Father, we give you all the glory. We have declared that there is no one that is like you. We love you. We want to dwell in your presence. So come on and have your way. God, we want to breathe you in every day. We want to feed you every day. And feed on you every day. Let's sing it together.
This is the air I breathe. This is the air I breathe. Your home.
This is the air that I breathe. Everybody lift your voice.
This is the air I breathe. This is the air I breathe.
Your holy presence.
Your holy presence.
This is my daily bread. I dare to sing those words tonight.
This is my daily bread.
This is my daily bread. Yeah.
This is my daily bread.
Your very word.
Your very word spoken to me.
And I'm desperate for you.
And I'm desperate for you.
Let this be your prayer. And I.
And I. I'm lost without you.
We're going up. You are the air I breathe.
You are the air I breathe. You are the air I breathe. Your holy presence living in me.
My daily bread.
You are
Hallelujah, let us pray.
Katusabe.
Today is December 2nd.
Olwaleero bili omwezi gwe 12.
And we are here to in our Bible study.
Tuli wano kusoma bwo kuyiga Bible.
As I remember, I promised you that I'll be talking about faith.
Eranga nzijuka nabaganda nja kuogera nnyo kukiriza.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for the gift of life.
Kitaffe omukutwebaza olw'ekirabo eky'obulamu.
Thank you for the gift of salvation.
Webaza olw'ekirabo eky'obulokozi.
And for your provision.
Era wamu n'ebisuubizo byo.
Bless the reading of your word.
Ekigambo kyo kiweebwa omukisa.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Mu linnya lya Yesu sabye.
Amen.
Amen.
We want to remind you.
Twagala okubajjukiza.
That we are still in the days of COVID. When you come to the house of God,
or
when you go to the public, remember to put on your mask. And always remember to wash your hands. If you don't have access to water, walk with your small bottle of sanitizer. We need to protect ourselves, not to spread the virus to other people. Life has no spare. You have one life, you must guard it, and you protect it. Amen.
Amen.
So we are still in the book of Hebrews. But today we are going to continue with our message of faith. And today we are going to talk about the word of faith. Faith is a spiritual force. And it is produced by hearing the word of God. The reason why I love faith in the Bible. Many of us we struggle. not knowing the word of God. So go with me in the book of Romans chapter 10 verse 17. The Bible says that, so then faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. So faith is produced by hearing the word of God. Faith is an interaction of the human spirit with the word of God. An interaction of the human spirit with the word of God. Many believers, we struggle that when the word of God when we hear the word of God, stays in our mind, in our knowledge. It never leaves our mind to go deep in our spirit. Remember, you are a spirit being. And God is a spirit being. And the word of God is a spirit. So the word of God must interact and mix with your spirit. It must take a root inside your spirit. Deep in your spirit. Once it takes a root inside of you, then it's going to produce results. Every time you hear God's word, faith comes. Faith comes by hearing and hearing the word of God. Faith does not come by reading. The Bible says that faith comes by hearing the word of God. In Romans chapter 10 verse 14, the Bible says very clearly, how then shall they call on him in whom they have not believed? And how shall they believe in whom they have not heard? And how shall they hear without a preacher? So the whole purpose of preaching is to cause people to believe and have faith in God. Why do we preach? The main purpose is to cause people to believe and have faith in God. Faith comes from hearing the word of God. Let me tell you, also fear comes by hearing the words of the devil. In the days we are living in, a COVID-19 pandemic has caused more fear in everyone because of what we hear on the social media, of what we hear from other people. What we are hearing is bombarding our mind with fear. So the news you hear will create fear in you. But if you want your faith to grow, you must hear constantly the word of God. The more you hear and meditate on God's word, the more faith you get. Let me repeat. The more you hear and meditate on God's word, the more faith you get. We have to hear it in our hearts. Some people only listen to the sound of the word of God and they never get anything. There is a difference between hearing and listening. Many believers, they listen to the word of God, God. But in their lifetime, they never hear the word of God. So these people will never develop any faith. The greatest challenge we have as believers is to work on our faith. Because the Bible says very clearly, without faith, you cannot please God. You cannot move God. You cannot see signs and wonders taking place in your life. The higher you develop your faith, as you meditate on God's word, miracles and signs will take place in your life. Fear works in the opposite way. Fear comes from meditating on what the devil says about your situation. Let me repeat again. Fear works the opposite way. Fear comes from meditating on what the devil says about your situation. The devil can bombard your mind with all the negative information. And you start to meditate on the situation. And you think about it. The more you meditate about it, you don't see any way out. You see the closed doors. You see defeat. You see failure. And then you give up. That's how the devil works. So fear comes by hearing. And faith in God comes by hearing the word of God. That's why God commands us to meditate on his word. As believers in the days we are living in, these are the days our hearts to be full of the word of God. So that we are not moved by what we are seeing and hearing,
we'll
be moved by the word of God. But that word of God must take root in your spirit. If the word is just a knowledge in your mind, it will never work. That's why you have so many believers today. They say the Bible doesn't work. God doesn't love me. How come that God doesn't love you? He loved you so much, and he sent his only begotten son. His love to you is too much. There is no way you can describe it. You just need to get the revelation that God loves you. When you get that revelation that he loves you, then your faith will be activated by meditating on the word of God. God told his servant Joshua, when he was about to take a big responsibility of taking the children of Israel to the promised land, one of the promises he told Joshua, the things he must do is in the book of Joshua chapter 1, verse 8. This book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate in it day and night, that you may observe to do according to all that is written in it. For then you will make your way prosperous, and then you have good success. Success All of us, we are looking for success. We want to succeed in life. We don't want to be failures. We don't want to be mediocres. We want to live a victorious life. But God gave the greatest key to Joshua. That key to everyone. Meditate on my word. He says that this the word of God shall not depart from your mouth. Your mouth must be full of the word of God. Because what is inside of you will come out. So what is inside of you? What are you thinking of? In the days we are living in, the Bible teaches us that the word of God must take place in our lives. We must meditate on it day and night. The Bible tells us in 2 Corinthians chapter 2 verse 15, the Apostle Paul was telling his dear son Timothy, advising him how to overcome the challenges of life. And he advised him, started to show yourself approved to God. A worker man that needs not to be ashamed. Rightly dividing the word of truth. Study, meditate on the word of God. To prove yourself to God that you trust Him, you believe in Him. Reading the word of God, study and memorize. In the days we are living in, I remember when I was growing up in our Sunday school, our teachers, they could tell us to memorize Bible verses. And for the last 50 years, those verses I learned in the Sunday school, they are still inside of me. And I think about them and I meditate about them day and night. They have helped me, they have sustained me in life. But in the days we are living in, we have believers who have Bibles. They don't read them. They don't study them. They don't take time to have verses inside of them. They don't memorize the word of God. Many of us, we have left that habit. If there is inside of you, when the enemy comes, he will destroy you. Remember, Jesus defeated that devil,
yes, ya wangula Satan,
by saying what God was saying to the devil.
Many
of us, we are just empty vessels. So when the enemy comes to us, he finds there is no word in us. When Jesus was telling his disciples in John 15, he told them that if my word is in you and I am in you, ask whatever you want. What we need is the word of God. We need to read and study and memorize the word of God and meditate on it day and night. The Bible is teaching us to be strong. Unless there is a word you are meditating on, when the enemy comes, and he finds there is no word of God, he will crush you down. We have many crushed believers in the days because they don't know that the word of God is so powerful. And that word comes by hearing. When you hear the word of God, when you hear the word of God, you start to meditate on it. And you allow the word of God to go deep inside of you. There is no situation or circumstance you are going to face in life and overcome your life. As believers, we need to strengthen our faith. Faith is like a physical muscle, can be developed and built. Faith can be strengthened. Faith can be weakened. The doctors, they tell us that if you don't use your muscles, if you don't exercise, your muscles will be weak. Many of us, we have faith, but many of us, we have never used our faith. That's why our faith has never developed. The greater is your faith, the greater the miracles you are going to receive. What does the Bible tell us? In the book of Romans chapter 14 verse 1, there is a verse which it teaches us that in him, him that is weak in the faith, receive ye, but not to doubtful disputation. Romans chapter 4, verse 19 and 20, it talks about Abraham. And being not weak in faith, he considered not his own body, now dead, when he was about 100 years old, neither yet the deadness of Sarah's womb. He staggered not at all the promises of God through unbelief, but was strong in faith, giving glory to God, not being weak in faith. Remember, Abraham got the promise from God when he was 75 years old, and God told him that you are going to produce a son. But Abraham waited for 25 years. The question, what did he do between the promise and the fulfillment of the promise? In the 25 years, his faith was seriously tested. He received so many negative words. He was attacked by so many people. They laughed to him. They called him a crazy man. And day by day, his body was getting weaker and weaker and weaker. There was no sign that they are going to produce it. Abraham and Sarah, they got older.
Abraham, wamune mchala we Sarah,
but remember, that never changed the word of God.
Why?
Because Abraham heard clearly. The promise of God was ringing in his ears. The promise of God was whispering inside of him. Abraham, you are going to have a son. Abraham, you are going to have a son. Abraham, you are going to have a son. And how did Abraham develop his faith? Every day, the Bible tells us, God took Abraham and showed him the stars of the stars of the sky. And he took him and showed him the showers of the sun, the sand on the shores. Every night, Abraham could go out and look at the stars in the sky. And he could see, oh, these are my children. Then during the day, he could walk on the shores of the sea and see the sand, and he could say, my children will be like more than the sand. And from there he could raise his hand and say, praise the Lord, glory be to God. He was praising God. He was thanking God. For the last 25 years, the way we build our faith is by keeping praising and thanking God. Because faith says, I have my promise. If I have it, I have to thank God and praise God and thank God. So Abraham did that for the last 25 years. What do you do when God makes a promise to you and nothing is coming to pass? Many of us, we complain. Many of us, we believe the lies of the enemy. Even we believe what the devil is telling us. We believe the negative dreams. Instead of believing God's word, remember, God's word is the source of your faith. Not anything else. It is the word of God. The word must take a root inside your spirit. And every day, you must thank God. The key to maintain strong faith is your mind. If your mind is full of doubts and uncertainties, you will not experience the blessings of God. If your mind is certain and is sure that God's word is true and that it will not fail, you have faith to overcome an obstacle that Satan may place in your path. Proverbs chapter 23, verse 7. The Bible says very clearly, for as he thinks in his heart, so is he. What is in your spirit? The ideas that you have in your mind about God, about yourself, about your circumstance, will determine the outcome of everything you do in life. Let me repeat again. For as he thinks in his heart, so is he. The ideas that you have in your mind about God, about yourself, about your circumstances, will determine the outcome of everything you do in life. Remember, as a believer, the Holy Spirit resides inside of you. The impressions you carry in your spirit will cause you to succeed or fail. This is a spiritual law. What you believe is the most important thing about you. What you believe is the most important thing about you. Satan knows that if he can get you to believe something other than God's word, you never experience the blessing of God. The devil will try to influence you with the negative thoughts. Through every opportunity he can take. Sometimes things seem like there's no way in the natural that you are going to receive what God has promised to. Always remember, if God promised, you have a right to believe it. God does not want you to live according to what you see in the world. He wants you to live by faith. 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 7. The Bible says very clearly, for we walk by faith, not by sight. God wants us to be bigger inside. He wants us to be bigger inside than the world around us. The word of God and the spirit of God can become greater inside of you than all the negative impossibilities of life will disappear. The Bible says in the epistle of John, the first epistle of John, chapter 4, verse 4. Ye are of God, little children, and overcome them. Because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Remember, deliverance always comes from inside out. Deliverance comes from inside out. Your deliverance starts inside your spirit. Before God can change something in your life, He must have a place to start. Your faith is going to be the platform that He will use to work from. Let your faith be the platform. Your belief is what He has promised. It's going to be the spark that causes God's power to begin manifesting itself on your behalf. What you believe is your faith. Is your faith in success? Is your faith in success and victory? Or is your faith in defeat and failure? The key is to believe what God said in His word. In the book of Romans chapter 4 verse 21, the Bible says very clearly, and being fully persuaded that what He had promised, He was able to perform. This is our brother Abraham. He was fully persuaded. He knew beyond any shadow of doubt that God is not a liar. If God has promised you, God is responsible to make it to come to pass. But what do you do between the time of promise and the time of fulfillment. It's the time when you keep on praising God and thanking God. Never worry about the time frame. Many of us, we are treating God like a microwave. God is not like a microwave. Where you put a cup of tea and you boil it in seconds. God does everything according to his time. He has his timing for everything. So time may pass by, but never worry about that. That time which passes by without seeing anything, that time which passes by and we go through the trials and hardships and we don't see any answer, we are just walking in the darkness, is the time the devil uses to speak louder that it's not God's will. Let me tell you, brothers and sisters, we have Abraham, the great hero of faith, the man who believed God by hearing the word of God daily. He kept his spirit to hear the word of God. Allow your inner man, allow your spirit constantly day by day to hear only the word of God. You must block your ears not to hear the words of the enemy. Many negative words will come. You'll be attacked from different corners, but always remind yourself, what does God say? What did he say about me? What is he saying about my situation? What is he saying about my family? What is he saying about my nation? Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. As we continue to study about faith, because without faith, we cannot please you. We are living in the toughest days where you have told us that the just shall live by faith. Help us to develop our faith and to build it day by day as we meditate on the word of God and continually keep the word of God on our mind. Help us, Lord, to continually speak the word of God against every situation opposing us. In Jesus' name we pray. Let us meet on Wednesday. God bless you all.